Welcome to this how-to video. Here I will show you how to transfer the process data of your IO-Link sensor to your controller in an EtherCAT network. The goal of this presentation is to show the communication between an IO-Link sensor and an EtherCAT network. In this presentation, we will use a temperature sensor from IFM and integrate it into an Omron PLC using Sysmac Studio. There will be a total of 3 steps. We will start by establishing the connection between the IO-Link master and the PLC. Then the IO-Link master will be configured using Sysmac Studio. After the configuration, we will do some programming to read out the process data of the temperature sensor. Before we start, here is a list of the necessary hardware and accessories. First of all, we need a notebook or PC with Sysmac Studio installed. Sysmac Studio is the automation software from Omron. Besides, we need the following hardware: a PLC with EtherCAT field bus interface, in this presentation NX1P2, an IO Link master, in this presentation AL1332 from IFM, and a temperature sensor, in this presentation TN2105 from IFM. For the power supply, we use the 24VDC power supply DN4012 from IFM. For the connection of this hardware, we need 2 Ethernet cables and 1 sensor cable. The Omron NX1P2 PLC has 2 different RJ45 Ethernet ports. The upper built-in Ethernet IP port should be used to connect the Sysmac Studio support software. The lower built-in EtherCAT port is connected to the IO-Link master. All connections are shown on the right side as an example. The IO-Link temperature sensor is connected to port number 2 of the master. Besides the hardware, we also need some software and auxiliary tools to make the whole process work. As mentioned in the former slides, Sysmac Studio is the programming software for the Omron PLC. It brings the hardware and the software world together. The ESI file of AL1332 describes the IO-Link master in the PLC. It adds the master to the hardware catalog in Sysmac Studio. In order to read the process data of an IO-Link sensor, we have to know how much memory space must be reserved for it and which data is transmitted in which order. This information can be found in the IODD file of the sensor. We come to the first step. After we have installed all the necessary software and connected all the hardware, we can start the configuration. The first step is to set the IP addresses of the notebook and the Omron PLC. They have to be in the same network segment. This means the first 3 numbers of the IP addresses of the notebook and the PLC have to be identical. In this presentation, they have to be set to 192.168.250.x. We start with the IP address of the notebook. The IP address of the notebook is set to 192.168.250.2. The subnet mask of the notebook is set to 255.255.255.0. The subnet mask is used to divide a large IP network into several small subnetworks. Now we change the IP address of the Omron PLC. We create a new project and change the device type and the version according to the hardware. The device type and the version can be found in the ID information on the side of the product. In this presentation, the device type is NX1P2-1040DT1, and the version is 1.47. Before we change the IP address of the Omron PLC, we have to know its current IP address. For this, we can use the network browser in the folder Communications Middleware Utilities. In the presentation, Sysmac Studio is installed on a virtual machine, so we choose Ethernet Hub Connection. If you have installed Sysmac Studio directly on your notebook PC, you can choose Direct Ethernet Connection. Then click Browse, and the current IP address of the PLC will be shown below. If the IP address is not 192.168.250.x, we can change it in Sysmac Studio. Here we set the IP address of the PLC to 192.168.250.1. The last number has to differ from the last number of the notebook's IP address. Then we can check if the communication works. Choose the method of connection with the PLC. As mentioned before, Sysmac Studio is installed on a virtual machine, so we choose Ethernet connection via a hub. Enter the IP address and click on Ethernet communication test. If everything is configured correctly, the communication test shows the result, test OK. If you receive an error message, check your hardware and software network settings. In order to configure the IO-Link Master AL1332 in Sysmac Studio, we have to install its ESI file first. After registration on the IFM homepage, you can download the ESI file. Now we add the master to the hardware catalog in Sysmac Studio by installing its ESI file. Right-click on the master, the PLC controller, and choose Display ESI Library. Click on Install Folder and choose the downloaded ESI file. Once the ESI file is installed, the hardware catalog shows the referring devices. Now we can add the IO-Link device to the network using drag and drop. Now the master is added to the network. The next step is to modify the device name and the node address on the right side. The device name does not necessarily need to be changed, but we can modify it for a better overview in the network topology. A unique node address must be given to the device because it is related to the communication between the master and the slave. Then we click on Edit Module Configuration to configure the ports of the IO-Link master. In the second step, we start with the configuration of the IFM IO-Link Master AL1332. Since the temperature sensor is connected to port number 2 of the IO-Link Master, we will configure IO-Link Channel 2. To confirm how much memory space must be reserved for the sensor, we should check the IODD file of the sensor. The IODD PDF of the temperature sensor TN2105 file can be found on the IFM website. The cyclic process data of the temperature sensor TN2105 has a total length of 2 bytes. The minimum option is a 4-byte input. This will be sufficient for the sensor as it only transmits 2 bytes of data. Drag and drop IOL in 4-byte on IO-Link Channel 2. For a better overview, you can name the configured port if you want, as shown here. Another configuration of the ports, which can be seen here, is done by the software by default. After the configuration, we click on the yellow symbol, Online. Now we want to check if there is data coming in from the sensor. To do this, we synchronize the configuration with the controller, or in other words, we download the configuration to the PLC. We select all elements for the transfer. Since this is only an example setup, we can ignore the warnings and error messages. After the download, we go to IO map in the directory and open the slot of our sensor. As previously configured, it is connected to port number 2, which translates to slot number 1 as counting starts from 0. In the last column, we can see some data being displayed. This is the data that is transmitted directly from the sensor. As it is difficult for us to relate these two values to the actual temperature, we need to do some programming to get the correct temperature value. This will be shown in the final step. To calculate the correct temperature value, we first need to understand how the sensor transmits the data. As we can see, bit 0 and bit 1 in byte 0 contain the information about the status of the sensor's two switching outputs. The remaining bits are used to transfer the temperature value. Depending on the controller, the bytes may be read in a different order to that specified in the IODD. In our case, the bytes are swapped. For better understanding, we call the low order byte TEM-L, and the high-order byte, TEM-H. This is done in the I.O. map we are currently using. Once logged out, you can double-click directly next to byte 0 and byte 1 and name them accordingly. In order to start programming, we navigate to our POU program organization unit on the left-hand side. To get the correct temperature value, we need to bring the data in the right order and then do some bit shifting. To do this, we create additional internal variables. We will now take a closer look at our programming example. We are using the ST language, but Sysmac Studio also supports ladder diagram and function block programming. You can use different methods to get the correct value. Here is one example of how to do this. All blue text represents functions or operators. Let's start with the first two lines of code. The data transferred directly from the sensor to Sysmac Studio is of the unsigned integer type, which you can also see in the IO map table in the data type column. However, Sysmac Studio doesn't allow programming using the unsigned integer type. Therefore, we have to convert it to Word. The temperature value has a total length of 2 bytes, so the word type is sufficient. Let's go back to our initial example. We take the two name bytes temL and temH and fill them with the incoming values that we can see in the IO map. The sensor shows a temperature of 26.6 degrees Celsius on the display. At the same time, byte 0 shows a decimal numerical value of 4, and byte 1 shows a decimal numerical value of 41. Both values are displayed in binary form. Now let's see what happens when we transfer both values to the word data type. As you can see, the values of each byte remain the same, but they are now stored in a different part of memory. Our next goal is to convert the data structure to the one described in the IODD. We start by moving our high-order byte to the correct position using the SHL operator. SHL means bit shift left, in our case, 8 bits. The result is named SHL data. We continue combining both words using the comb operator. This result is named comb data. In our example, 1065 is read out in decimal format. This is not yet the current temperature value because it still includes bit 0 and bit 1, the switching outputs of the sensor. We therefore jump to the next programming step and use the SHR operator to shift these 2 bits to the right. The result is named SHR data. If we now read out this value again in decimal format, we get 266, which is already very close to 26.6 degrees ICE. As a final step, we change the data format from word to real to be able to display a decimal point and then multiply the whole value by 0.1. This gradient can be found in the IODD PDF of the sensor. When the program is downloaded to the controller and we are logged in, the calculated value and the sensor display now match. Thank you for watching. Check it out. There are more informative videos.